It's time now for Police on the Scene with a Crime Prevention Lean, with your host, police officer and national crime prevention professional, J.D. Dhein.
Hey, welcome. I'm J.D. Dhein, and we have actually our producer, Tim Kretschmann, next to me.
Yeah,
and
that's me.
That is you, and we've got the grab bag question of the month here.
Yeah, you know, people have asked me about this at work, and I said, well, I know the super cop. I'm going to go ahead and ask him. So if a police officer comes to your home, how do you know it's a real police officer and not somebody that's doing something that they shouldn't be doing?
Yeah, we get that question a lot with traffic stops, too.
I mean, I don't know from this badge. I don't know if this is an official badge or something in the Halloween store.
I mean, most of the time, you see an officer dressed in full gear with a radio going, and you see a squad car from your jurisdiction out front. I mean, that's a police officer. But with that said, Tim, if somebody comes dressed as you, like a detective, you know, undercover officer, plain clothes, as they say, might not be as clear driving an unmarked vehicle. Most police officers, if it's something where they need to talk to you, are going to probably try to contact you first via phone to see if you're home. Not always. They might be canvassing the neighborhood, etc. And real police officers aren't going to have any issues with you questioning who they are with identification, etc., behind a locked door until you know for sure. If you're still not sure, there's nothing wrong with calling your local police department and saying, hey, I'm Tim Kretschmann, I live at this address. Is one of your officers at my house right now, and this is where I live? I mean, they'll be more than happy to let you know that.
So now, where do I get the phone number?
Well, I mean,
I'm supposed to have that at my phone.
You should.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
You yell at me about this all the time.
And know your jurisdictions. You should have your phone numbers there, if not in your phone, and be able to check that. So, good question.
Well, thank you, officer.
And I'll tell you what, as long as we set it to the traffic stop is another thing. Officers who never have an issue, especially with women, and that's, I would say, more than you would be going to a lit area if, you know, there isn't a squad or it's an unmarked, they're not going to have an issue with that. And most of them are really good about pulling you over in an area that's, you know, well lit. And if not, and it's an unmarked squad per se, and a person that doesn't have any identifiable marks as a police officer, they have no issue with that. So that's, you know, always if you're not sure, you know, you can always ask your local police department crime prevention officer, probably going to say something similar to me, but good to check with them too what they prefer to do. So with that said, I'm Officer J.D. Dhein with our producer Tim Kretschmann, and we are 10-8.